Hello, I'm Jack. Welcome to my channel, Practical Programming with Dr. Su. In this video series, you will learn everything you need to get started with WGPU graphics programming in Rust. In the last video, I explained how to use the uniform buffer to create a 3D cube. This contains a lot of code and mathematics. This video will be much simpler and shorter than the last video. It is based on the example presented in the last video. Here, I will show you how to animate our 3D cube by rotating it continuously as shown here. In addition, we will check how the depth stencil attribute affects our 3D cube. Here, we will use the gate tool to clone the source code used in the last example, and then make corresponding changes to that source code to build the project used in this video. Now, let's start Visual Studio Code directly from Windows Start menu here. Here is the Visual Studio Code interface. Now, let's start a new terminal window. CD code folder. Now, make a new directory MDWGPU08. This new WGPU08 folder is created successfully. Now, CD into it. We can then clone the source code used in the last video. Git clone WGPU07. After this command, we leave a space and a period. This will place or our source code in the current folder. So run this command so we can check use direct. You can see here the source code is indeed in the current folder. Now open this folder from Visual Studio Code open folder code WGPU8. Open this folder. Now here contains the source code used in the last video. We can reuse most code used in the last video, including the cedar code, matrix and transformations, and vertex data. All this code we can reuse without any changes. Here we only need to make some changes is main.rs file. From src folder, open main.rs file. And most of the code in this file is also similar to that used in the last video, except that in order to rotate our 3D cube continuously, we need to update the model matrix. First, we define a constant named animation speed. So we define a constant here, animation speed. Then we need to replace the update function here. We have an update function, it's empty right now. We need to replace this update function with the new code. This function accepts dt, the time duration, as its input argument, called time duration, which will be used as our animation parameter. Inside this function, we rescale this duration dt by the animation speed. So you can control the animation speed by change this constant. We then recreate the model matrix. You can see the model matrix. Use transform, create a transformation. Here, this translation doesn't change and the scaling doesn't change, but we use a new rotation vector here, sine dt, cosine dt, and zero. This is a new rotation vector. This means we will constantly change the rotation angles around the x and y axis. Next, we recreate the model view projection matrix by multiply by projection matrix, view matrix, and model matrix. This model matrix will be updated continuously with this relation here. Finally, we update the uniform buffer with this new model view projection matrix by calling the right buffer. This way, we also update the uniform buffer. This uniform buffer will be time dependent because this is a function of the time duration. Another place we need to make some changes is inside the main function. Here, we need to define the start time. Start time is called instant now. Here we have a state update function. We need to define the duration function dt. See here. The now we call the now, and the start time we also define this start time here. So this difference we define as dt, this duration. So now update right now the function is dt as input argument. So we need to put this argument inside here. Here we define time duration and call the update function with this duration to rotate our 3D cube. Now we finish the modifications to this min.rs file. We can save this file. Up to now, we have completed all programming. Now we can run the following command on the terminal window to create our cube. So open a new terminal window and run cargo run. Okay, here is our cube. This cube rotates continuously, you can see here. Next, we want to check how the depth stencil attribute affects our 3D cube. So first we close this window. First of all, let's go to the render pipeline here. You can see we have a depth stencil attribute here. We can comment out this code and set it to none here. And also we need to change here from the render path descriptor. We need to remove the depth stencil attachment because we set it to none already. So we comment out this code and set the depth stencil attachment to none. Now save this file and rerun the program. Cargo run, see what happened. You can see we get unexpected results. The sides of the cube are drawn on the screen, but they overlap each other in a strange way. The problem here is that when WGPU draws the cube triangle by triangle, it is simply writes over pixels even though something else may have been drawn here before. In this case, WGPU will draw triangles in the back over triangles at the front. The depth stencil attribute tells WGPU when to draw over a pixel and when not to. To avoid such strange rendering issues in WGPU, I suggest that you always set this attribute for 3D objects. So now we set this attribute back. Close this window. Then I comment this code and comment out this now. And also here, come out here and comment this code. Save it. If you read wrong the program, you will get a normal cube. Now we have completed this example. In next video, we will discuss how to create a light model in WGPU. Thank you for watching.